industry clothing, and a fashion was a totally different thing, whereas now they take inspiration from fashion and create their own
little designer labels within the
Mad. It's the only way I would really go over the top and spend a huge amount of money on something if it's timeless.
Yeah.
You can wear it in years to come. Like a little black dress.
Right, guys, I've got a few CDs for us to look at. A few blasts from the past.
Oh, no.
Okay. See the day. That's not that old, good. Really.
It's all right.
Well, you're still ugly, though. Ugly as sin.
A bit girly for me.
No, I quite like that. I really like those dresses. I know they're a bit different.
They're just really pretty.
Weird.
You feel like a girl fairy in them. I like it. Will you ever see the this is horrendous, I'll be honest.
Mind that one.
This is I think we're alone now.
Oh,
and they went on some mad like rave kind
of. That was kind of a weird patch we went through. Sarah, I think you look gorgeous.
It's quite punky, isn't it?
As for the rest of us.
I know.
I'm sure there's somewhere I looked.
What's this?
What is this?
Dog rough on some.
Wake me up.
No. No, you see, this is definitely a losing.
Why do we look sweaty?
I mean,
we look like the sweat dropping off. Yeah. Wake me up before I drop out on you. You treat me rough to show that you care, and I just can't refuse, baby. If I had a promise from you, I'd get up and out of my bed instead of being subdued.
Oh my
god. It's not
god.
The worst. It's definitely worse.
They were easy to dance in anyway. The heels were not that big.
Put it down.
Scarred enough.
Oh, God!
This is the one I was talking about.
Hair and makeup, I can't complain.
Sarah, you look gorgeous
again. This is no good advice.
Hair and makeup, fine.
You look very twiggy or was blonde.
Blondie.
This is red and black the first time round.
Oh, what are they?
The tone of niggas.
I like a witch with that long skirt.
I'm say, it wasn't really our thing at the time.
Cheryl, I don't.
That's not me. I don't need no good advice.
I'm already wasted. No.
I'll stand by you.
That was really the same day as the sweaty day.
I'm Sarah from Girls Aloud, and welcome to the set of our new video.
They are covering me in coffee,
and it's freezing, and it's dank.
I'm not quite sure what they've got prepared in there for us, so I'm quite excited to see, so come with me and we'll have a look.
Every time I walk these shorties, getting smaller.
Just about to roll out from under the car, so let's hope it doesn't fall on me because I'm getting scared.
Right, so this is it. This is the set. This is where Cheryl's been doing her bit with all the tyres and everything. And I think I'm going to be in the truck.
To keep evolving, just what way you look and what just everything has to keep changing because styles change, styles of music change, dancing, so you just change your look.
Nicola Roberts, who's 16, waitress student and part-time singer.
What does that mean, part-time?
Oh, no, I just made it up.
I just made it up, yeah. And she just played her.
For you are the place where all my thoughts go hiding. Right under your clothes is where I'll find them. Underneath.
Thank you.
Like her voice.
Yeah, good voice.
Great voice.
Thank you. I think you're nice. I don't think you're brilliant.
I think you should go through. You can sing well, and I think a lot of girls are like, my DVD look great. I think it's great.
I like this. Really good, but I was impressed with how clear your voice was. That in itself is fantastic. So you're going to London. Well done, Nicola.
Well, let it out. If you want to survive the next, I'd love you to go through. If you want to survive the next round, let that last come out.
See you in London.
I thought you could have done much better, you know. We cannot put everybody through the clever performance.
Even the last 50, there were girls there that went home that you think, no, you shouldn't have gone home. And honestly, I just do not know. I might ask actually and say, why am I here? Why am I, why have I come so far?
I bet you do want to be in the pop music business.
Yeah, life.
Yeah, really?
Yeah.
Well, we'll call you back tomorrow.
Like Kimberly, Nicola wasn't initially chosen to be part of the final 10. Well,
unfortunately, they won't ask you to go down to the house.
Okay.
Unfortunately, I just thought that overall, they had some stronger girls.
Like people saying, no, you did so well, that's not really what you need to hear. Because you just, it goes in one ear and comes out the other, you don't even think about it.
Tell you what, my darling, it's their loss.
But Nicola was soon to receive a pleasant surprise, and this time the honour fell to Hayley and me.
The thing is, you're going to have to remember the number because it's the number for the house. And you're obviously going to have to remember that because you're going to have to give it to your mum and everyone else because you're going to be in there tonight.
Oh my God. You get to house.
You are going to the house.
You're going to
be.
Don't make me cry, because me. You can cry. Come here, mum.
You can speak to Amy yourself tonight. We don't need to give her the number.
You don't have to watch on telly because you'll be there on Saturday. You'll be on that stage.
And you're going to knock him dead.
Okay, seriously, how many of you dating here?
Me and Nicola.
Two. That's a pretty poor show at best, isn't it? Seriously, that's pretty crappy, I'm saying. Who would you go for if you have a choice in the, you know, name a famous person we all know? Who would you go for?
Pharrell, I would go for, from the Neptunes.
Nice.
Ashley Cole. He's a footballer.
You fancy that idea?
Yeah.
Does that not hold, is not Posh Spice killed all that kind of footballer thing?
Nah,
no, you're a footballer?
Personally, I don't know.
He's handsome, he's got great legs, we'll take him.
Open to ideas.
He's got a bit of a wreck.
Absolutely. Yeah.
Is it on? Oh, there it is. Check it. Yes. Hi, I'm DJ Keith, and because I'm on telly, a lot of people ask me, make it exciting, move, yeah? Move camera around. Pops. Because I'm on telly, a lot of people ask me to DJ, and I do, and I'm very good. A lot of people say to me, Keith, what sort of things do you play when you're DJing? And I tell them, records. Also, someone's parked a Volvo outside, if you can move it. Seriously, it's blocking passageway. You over there, yeah, thanks. So Kimberly's gonna be wearing the sound cancelling headphones. Can you hear anything? You'll be able to see what Kimberly's experiencing because she's got a special camera on her head that I bought from my mate who works at NASA. So you can see everything she's seeing. So without further ado, let's drop some tunes. Kimberly, you ready? You ready? Yeah, push it.
Oh, you're doing like I know what it is.
Who wants to guess?
I know what it is. I think I know what it is.
I've got my jacket on. Like,
I love that.
My DJ jacket.
what it is? Is it JLS, Everybody in Love?
We would absolutely love to go on a tour.
That's what we're aiming for. That's our aim, really.
That'll be the highlight of our careers if we do it all.
Yeah. We're just working on the album. The album's out now, and we're just promoting that and doing things in Europe and stuff. So, and then if the album does well and people want to come see a tour, then we'll do a tour, and hopefully it goes well.
Crowd absolutely rocked.
When we actually did the performance, they were going mad, absolutely mad.
And they had Girls Aloud posters.
Cheering, it's weird cheering when we got out there.
As the girls drive to their next TV show, the midweek results come in. Their worst result today is a number 9, and they need to do better.
We just received the midweek today. A whole lot of history, and it's number 8 at the moment. So we've never had one that's not been in the top 10 yet. So thank God it's in the 10. So let's just hope it goes up to top 5, because that would be better, really. See what happens.
Could you just give yourselves a little introduction of what you both bring to the band?
Oh, God. I would like you to give your impression.
Of what you all bring to the band?
What you think, just from what you know.
I think Nadine brings Larry shoes.
I knew you were going to say that one more.
Today.
Just because before we started, Nadine was told to go over there, and then because she had Larry shoes on.
Go sit over there. They said, I know your shoes is taking up too much of the screen. So I was like, oh, okay.
All right. I'd say Cheryl brings glamour.
Oh, go on.
Finesse.
I like that.
Look at you.
Meow.
Nicola brings.
Now you're going to stop that now.
I can top it. I've got encyclopedias at home.
Have you?
Come on
then. I'm waiting.
I'd say Nicola brings.
Say something nice.
Like an English rose beauty.
Yeah.
Thank you. Kimberly, I'd say brings something hot.
No matter.
Something spicy. I think.
Good. Oh,
crap. We'd probably bring like crisps.
Oh, nice one.
Alicia, you bring like the rock and roll.
That's right.
That's quite good,
yeah. Thank you.
Very nice. Yeah,
well done.
No, not for me, no round.
Okay, maybe not.
Oh, come on, Larry's shoes.
Bringing attention to the Larry's shoes. They're supposed to be tucked away.
The themes reflect completely the album. The album tracks, songs that have been hit so far, like Love Machine, Biology, Sound of the Underground, ones that people really, really love. So it was a matter of mixing the old classics with the new album tracks and getting a show that flowed. Favourite song to sing is Sound of the Underground. I love that song. I'm so proud that it's our song.
The section where we do Push It and Control of the Knife, the little bit more urban section, shall we say, is my favourite part of the talk. And it's literally that last note where I go, get low, bang, and I'm like, please come, we're just waiting for the lights to go out so I can put my head down and just breathe. So that is probably the best section, but the hardest section at the same time.
And then Control of the Knife, I love that. It's really hard, like your legs, your thighs are like trembling by the end. I really enjoy performing it. And then I'm sweating afterwards, so it's like healthy to sweat, and then that's what I tell myself anyway. Janet Jackson sweats.